Today we'll be looking at work by Mark Devcich using creative movement with Susan Jordan of Seniors Dance.
I'm Susan Jordan from Seniors Dance, here today to introduce you to creative movement. Movement is really good for our physicality, and it is also really good to stimulate our minds and to work creatively. So I hope you'll enjoy what we're about to do. So let's start with a physical warm-up. If you're 82, please stand up and do it. But you will need to have a chair or something to support you for one or two of the exercises. If you're unable to stand, then I suggest you sit in a chair like this, not an armchair, but an upright chair that doesn't have any arms so that you can move your arms. So let's start into the warm-up. Let's start with our shoulders, first of all. Our shoulders get very stiff as we get older. All our joints do. Roll them back. The more we move them, the more they lose their tension. And one arm, and the other arm, and do that again. Now I want to take you through some letters. The major letters of the alphabet. This is a Y. A capital E, which is on its side. Make sure you lift under the arms then. Drop the elbows down and you get a W. Stretch the arms out and you get a T. And then round the arms and you get an O. Let's try that again. Y. E. W. T. O. And one more time. So I've got sort of warmed up the shoulders a bit. I'm holding on to support here. Let's go through the feet. It's really important that we keep our feet mobile. The more we can move our feet, the better it is to walk. And as we get older, we don't want to suffer. It means we will fall over. So I'm going through my toes. And now let's stretch down to leg and flex at the ankle. Flex. And point, flex and point, and I'm holding on to the foot for support. And the other foot, and flex and point, flex and point, flex and point, flex and point. Now I'm going to warm up the hip socket. So, really on the command, highly. So now step away from the chair, and I'll do some cross crawling. If you can, you're lifting up one leg and putting the opposite arm. So with the right leg, your left arm is coming across. That's if your balance is all right. If you can't manage that, then a simplified version of it is to touch your hip and not lift the leg up. And this is good for the brain. Okay, and then just behind me, just pop. That's a really quick one. Now we'll do some of this sitting down. So if you need to sit down, as I said before, sit in a firm chair and try and sit upright and sit sort of forward in the chair. We'll go over the arm movement again. Rolling the shoulders, bending the elbows. You can imagine your mouth elbow, touch it to the arm. Elbows, make circles. And then one arm and the other arm. So the memory we have to make in our letters, Y, E, W, T, and O. I'll do that one more time, Y, E, W, T, and O. Good, and then sitting down on the feet, so push through on the toes. Trying to make a difference between your toes and your metatarsal. Good, and then stretch out the leg and flex. If you want me to do more on the end of the chair, you can hold on to the chair and pull it in, and the other one, flexing, tension, flexing. And then, for the hip, you can't lift it very high, but at least you can do it more. And then we'll go into the chest. make sure you're using the opposite arm to release. Good, and then just the money on the space. So that's sort of warmed up the upper body and breathe. That's the warm-up thing. Now we're going to focus on Mark's work. We've got lots of diagonals and straight lines in this work. So we're looking at our root space. How far can you reach up on the diagonal? And imagine you've got a bit of a swing and you're reaching to the other diagonal, the down diagonal. And on the other side, and then you're down. I'll start up on a tall diagonal there, and then down. And the other diagonal, and then down. How tall can you go? How low can you go? How wide can you go? And what? So down here, it's our root space. And as we get older, we tend to pick up in three. You demand your root space. You're allowed to have it. Right, now we're going to look at negative space. Negative space, if you're looking at a chair or a piece of equipment you've got in the room, the space is where around the edge of the chair. Or going back to what we were doing with our arms, the wire, the negative space should be this space here. Okay? So we're going to look at Mark's through artwork now. And I'm going to put some music over for you. You might like to use that music, or you might like to use your own. We're going to use Mark's work as simulation for us to dance. Try not to look at what I'm doing. Try to use the whole idea of root space and also negative space. Okay. So let's put on the artwork and the music now.
So now step outside of your artwork, have a look at it, see all the diagonals, see all the cross lines, see all the negative spaces, and try and retain it in your mind. And I hope you've learnt from that, that your reach space is as big as you want to make it. And I do hope that that idea of creative dance has stimulated your own art making. Kia ora, ka pai.
Kia ora e te whānau, and thank you so much for joining us today. Please hit subscribe to enjoy more of our online resources for creativity and visit our website for more information and other resources. Special thanks to our supporters and funders for making this project possible. Ka kite anō, see you again.